So yesterday, CS Mithika Linturi was on Citizen TV and he seriously embarrassed the Kenya Kwanza administration. I honestly wish he hadn't gone for that interview with Sam Gituku. And in this video, I want us to highlight some of the things that took place in that interview, which I think were very, very embarrassing. And without wasting any time, let's get after it. Number one, Mithika Linturi could not accept that there were some fake fertilizers circulating in Kenya and instead decided to call them substandard. I mean, just some basic honesty is lacking with some of these CSs. Just listening to this exchange.
Away from that fake conversation, what is the opposite of fake?
Genuine.
So is the substandard fertilizer genuine?
The substandard, you know, this thing can only be understood by scientists when it comes to issues to defining what is correct, what is not correct, because the want will not, or an imitation will not apply across board to really to be used as an example of the other. So you must really compare, and I wish we had experts here, because they are the ones that will also tell you, if you feed this fertilizer at 25% of nitrogen or phosphorus at 10, can the plant really grow to a certain level? They will tell you it is yes, but it will be deficient of that particular nutrient. So the issue would be then, because it is deficient, it's malnourished, then the next thing is how you can remedy the situation.
So is it genuine?
What?
The fertilizer you're talking about, is it genuine?
The fertilizer I am talking about lacks the necessary percentages of the compounds as required indicated by a plant.
And also,
especially for the formation of the root,
and also as
for the formation of the leafing of the plant, and the immunity of the plant.
Okay.
So it will have taken less than what it is required.
So you don't want to commit another, it's fake.
You know, I'm telling you, it is not possible. And please understand that these are just semantics. People have taken this matter and politicized it. But if we were people who have no interest completely and are interested to explaining the public to understand the difference.
Yeah.
I honestly wonder why it's so hard for Waziri to admit that the fertilizer is fake, because if it is not genuine, then what else is it? It's fake. If we use that same reasoning, if I start selling fake Rolex watches and I'm apprehended by police, I will say those watches are not fake, they are substandard. Is that not one and the same thing? Moving along, Sam Gituku then asked Linturi to explain why he received information about the maize scandal from John Allan Nyamu and he ignored it. And Linturi claims he never received any such information and that he is not aware of such a thing. In fact, he was asking for emails and phone numbers so that he can go and do a follow-up. And the thing about Citizen is that these guys are very good at cornering people. The last time we had a UDA panel on Citizen talking about how the cost of unga has gone down, and immediately in that same interview, while it's ongoing, some Citizen journalists got in a vehicle, went to a supermarket and started televising live the actual cost of unga on the ground, and they were found to be lying. And in this particular instance again, Sam Gituku decided to call John Allan Nyamu and put him on air. Here's the tip.
I'm telling you, it was never brought to my attention, and that's why I'm challenging him to give us the phone number, the email address that he used, so that we can also try to check and know whether I'm lying or not.
Jonathan, what are you saying?
If Mr. Linturi is saying that it was not brought to his attention, it is not my responsibility, beyond reaching out via the official channels that we have done, to then take it to his office personally. He has official communication channels. We reached out via Kilimo. We spoke to Mr. Marete, who is in his office. We reached out. Our journalist, Ms. Mithihiri, wrote to him on the 15th of February this year. The story ran on the 10th of March. So this thing of saying that he was not served personally is not a personal. He is a cabinet secretary serving on behalf of the Republic of Kenya. He must remember that. And I'm taking very, very great exception to the fact that he keeps on dragging our name through the mud when it is us who have brought this issue to the attention of the public. Linturi, if he is worth his salt as the cabinet secretary, must apologize to our organization and to the nation for doing something like this.
And I agree with John Allan Nyamu, because once you use the relevant contact channels of the various ministries, you let them know that, hey, there is this problem, there is this problem, the burden can no longer be on you to get that message to the CS or the PS or the relevant people. You've done your part. John Allan Nyamu did his part. He let them know that there is fake fertilizers. He had evidence. He was ignored, and now this is a big national scandal. Even on this same channel, if you guys can remember, we did that video of the fake, I think, Middle East people conning people here in Kenya, pretending to be doing screening services for the various STDs that are prevalent in this country. And they are taking people's money, conning them. When you go to where they are saying they have an office, they have no office. We did that entire video here. In fact, I'll do my best to pin it up, Ochini. If I forget, just remind me and I'll do so. Even that has never been acted upon. So I won't be shocked if John Allan Nyamu is saying that there is a scandal and he has told the CS, or rather the ministry, and it has not been acted on. People wait for the president or the DP or the prime cabinet secretary or Kindiki to say something about something for something to happen. This Ministry of Agriculture, at the end of the day, is a very vital ministry. It is actually one of the backbones of this country. Even if we don't have a stable economy, people would always want to be able to afford to put something in their stomach. And that is why the president, when he came into power, he removed subsidies, because that's living a lie. We're living a life that's not ours and it's costing us. So he removed the subsidies and instead decided to subsidize the fertilizer because it's cheaper to do that and it ultimately yields better results. The cost of unga is low right now. But if this games of issuing fake fertilizer continues, you find a farmer went and bought 100 kgs of fertilizer, they're all fake. They have to go spend some more money to buy another 100 kgs to facilitate their various acres. That same farmer cannot incur losses. That's the thing people are missing. A farmer cannot incur a loss. Whatever expenses they make or expenditures, they do the math and they seek that in profit. So they'll end up giving us very high prices, which will skyrocket the cost of unga. So the president did the right step. Some people in the Ministry of Agriculture are taking that ministry backwards. I'm not saying it's the CS, but he is the responsible person. When you're at the top, if your ministry does well, you take the praise. If it does poorly, you take the blame. Because even if it's a low-level person, you're the one who hired that person. Or why did you not fire them? Or what action are you taking? So this interview, in my opinion, was very, very embarrassing. We need to be honest with each other. There was fake fertilizer, most of which was pebbles. You even wonder, were the farmers laying foundation for their building or were they laying foundation for their plants? But either way, guys, that's just my opinion. Do let me know your own comments about the Sam Gituku interview with Mithika Linturi. I'll do my best to read them and to give you a response. Now, in the event you're here for the first time, please go on and hit the subscribe button. And if you're watching from a different platform, just head on over to YouTube, search for David Wafula, hit the subscribe button. You're going to be getting a ton of content of this nature. If politics is something you're passionate about, this is definitely the one channel that you really, really need to subscribe to. All right, guys, adios. Thank you for choosing David Wafula as your primary news platform. We put countless hours in research, recording, and editing. By showing up each and every day to watch our videos, you encourage us to generate more videos for the viewers. We are on a mission to inform, educate, and build a better tomorrow. To our thousands of followers in a world full of presidents, kings, and queens, you are the real gem. Adios.